Hello, hello, hello. Thanks for watching my screencast on how to incorporate analytical reasoning, aka logic, into science content. I'm Kent. And last video, we talked about logic games and how they're awesome mini challenges for students to do in your science classroom. The example we brought up was that of math class and how math has a whole bunch of logic puzzles, anywhere from Sudoku, Ken, straights, and whatever that thing on the right is, math has a whole bunch of logic puzzles. And logic puzzles are great because they're quick to do. They are skills-based, which means there's no specific content knowledge that's required. They're logic-based, meaning that there's usually a set of conditions and students are required to build and test models to see if it fits those conditions. And a great place to get logic games and logic puzzles for a science classroom is in the law school admissions test, the LSAT, under the analytical reasoning section. And usually in this section, you're given passages and you're asked to analyze the information in those passages and solve a whole bunch of questions. So, although logic games are good to assess skills, we still have to find a way to connect analytical reasoning to curricular content, especially since we have to teach content in the science classroom. And the way to get around this is to use case studies, especially those with competing hypotheses. More on that later. First, the great thing about case studies is that we can use them in a variety of ways. And a great place to get case studies is at the University of Buffalo's website, the National Center for Case Study Teaching in Science. You should be able to find some case studies to fit any one of those, goals you're trying to reach. Now, what we call hypothesis case studies are awesome because in a hypothesis case study, students are given multiple sides to a scientific phenomenon, and they need to analyze the differences between those theories or those sides. Also, in a hypothesis case study, there's a variety of topics you can approach, and therefore it makes this very engaging. Especially if you choose something that there really might not be an answer to yet, and therefore it can also be fairly informal. It could just be like, the latest research, the latest guesses. It doesn't have to be rooted yet in all the right answers, all the formal research yet. Let's give you some examples, all right? These are some case studies that I've used in the past. For example, I have a case study about why humans sleep. And the three theories that I present in this case study is, number one, one of rest and repair. The fact that, the idea that maybe our bodies need to recharge and repair any body functions to prepare for the next day. Another theory is that we sleep because we need to save our brain needs to save energy in order to form synaptic connections and to get rid of non-essential connections. This is known as the synaptic homeostasis theory. And one other theory is that we sleep because we need to form memories, basically known as information consolidation. Now, from these three theories, we can basically pose interesting questions like this one. The idea that recently it was found that the brain triggers the release of cerebrospinal fluid, which flushes waste matter from the brain while individuals slept. So which theory with this finding, with this new evidence, bring support to? A, rest and repair, B, synaptic homeostasis, and C, information consolidation, or D, none of the theories. I'll give you a minute to pause the video if you want to select your answer. And welcome back. The answer is B, synaptic homeostasis, the idea that our brain basically flushes any non-essential connections, is kind of supported by the idea of cerebrospinal fluid being flushed, being present and flushing stuff away. Here's another example of a case study I've used, one about aging. So what causes aging? Well, I present students again with three theories. Number one, the idea that aging is actually programmed into our bodies from the start. Aging may be due to a slow buildup of damage, eventually leading to organ or body system failure. This is known as damage errors theory of aging. There's also one theory of aging saying that our body is trying to optimize energy use. Some systems are compromised because they have less energy. This is known as the trade-offs or disposable soma theory. Again, let's get to a question about these that I would present in this case study. Here's the question. Basically, scientists discovered that the lifespan of animals are extended when deprived of food. So which of the following theories would this evidence refute? I'll give you the opportunity to pause this video and key in your answer. And welcome back. The answer is E, theory three only. I'm not sure how many of you guys got that one, but maybe rewind and listen to theory explanations one more time. We're gonna continue on though to our third and final example, the one about yawning and why we yawn to begin with, why people or animals yawn. And the three theories presented is the idea that number one, we yawn because we need to remove carbon dioxide from our body, or we need to absorb or get in more oxygen into our bodies. Another theory behind yawning is that it's used to communicate a message or communicate environmental conditions, especially for animals that can't talk, right? And the third theory I present is the idea that yawning is to cool the brain, and there's some evidence for that as well in academic research. Here's the interesting question we ask. According to hypothesis two, yawning is to humans as, and I'll let you pause the video and choose your answer. And welcome back. The answer is C. Hypothesis two is really about communication. And the only, I guess, option here of communicating an idea is that of a traffic sign for drivers. Now, if you're thinking about writing your own hypothesis case studies from scratch, you can use these websites, sciencedaily.com, sciencealert.com, PLOS1 or Public Library of Science. These sites are great because they offer the most recent, I guess, research science news, and oftentimes the science news has kind of lets you know what the previous hypothesis was or other hypotheses explain the same phenomenon. And from there, you can research other hypotheses and build up a case study from there. Or you can just ask Google an interesting question. This is what I did with the aging example. This is what I did with the yawning example. I basically just had a question. I asked Google, and Google kind of came up with some search results and some theories. Now, if you want ones that are pre-packaged, you can take a look at like the American College Test. The science section oftentimes has passages where there are multiple hypotheses trying to explain one phenomenon. What's great about this is that, yes, it's all pre-written, and plus they have the answers and the questions. So this is great. Now, from these three videos, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, wow, so far I've presented ideas about logic, about case studies, about challenges, and content. So how do we put this all together into one thing that we can present to students? And really, that's for next time. Next time I'll tell you about how we put logic, case studies, challenges, and content all together for students. So until then, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next episode, and I hope to see you soon. Take care.